Drug use impacts HIV treatment and care for black sexual minority men in a lot of different ways. First, drug use impacts folks' ability to access proper health care services. It creates a competing interest and priority in accessing services. And it also creates an increased layer of stigma if people feel like they'll be judged by revealing that they are, in fact, using illicit substances by providers. Provider attitudes and beliefs impact black sexual minorities' ability to really engage in care and to a large degree. First of all, folks really want people who care about them, and it sounds so simple, but that's really a priority for this population. And a lot of times if patients feel that providers are not sensitive or not really invested or not genuine, it can really be a turnoff to accessing quality care and really engaging with healthcare providers. The first takeaway that I would say is that providers should really care about their patients. I mean, it sounds really simple, but the guys that I work with, they really can pick up on whether or not providers are genuine. And it really taps into a different level of cultural competency that I think we're not talking about. So cultural competency is like this weird nebulous kind of thing where people are like, all of these concepts about subpopulations we need to know. But sometimes it's just as simple as like greeting your patient, like, and caring about them. And that's like part of the humanity in everybody. And another thing that that providers should know is that people want to engage in healthcare. It's not true that people, you know, are not coming to clinics because they don't care, or there are a lot of really different social determinants of health that really impact black, gay, and bisexual men's health and whether or not they even access health care. To develop a rapport with black sexual minority men, we found this in one of the projects that I did, they really want folks to ask questions about who they are as individuals, assess their lifestyles, assess what are they interested in, what are their goals for their health and their lives, and also what are the antecedents that really bring them to the clinic in the first place. And those kinds of things guys are saying make them feel like the person is, the provider is really vested in their health and really, really, and really creates a level of being genuine that they will really appreciate and build that rapport. You know, there's a big push to increase access to biomedical prevention, you know, specifically with PrEP, and really engaging folks in pre-exposure prophylaxis and also HIV treatment adherence. But before we really proliferate those things, we really, really have to understand some of those social things, some of those developmental things that really impact black gay men's health, which is about trauma, which is about, you know, access to resources, which is about people feeling like they're not cared for in general, with, you know, feeling misunderstood. And those things are really what impact not only access to care, but health outcomes in general. So I really feel like as we really move forward to advanced biomedical prevention activities, we really need to target some of those social determinants as well.